country, don't you? It's not fun, is it?
No!
You don't like being called a slut, a whore, or it's your fault, do you?
No!
That's right, that's what they did to her. She had no choice in this. Even if she would have said no, or even agreed at first and then said no somewhere down the line, still rape. What they did to this girl was calculated. I mean, I wouldn't even call it a date rape, because a date rape is where you're on a date, and the guy goes too far, and you tell him no, and he won't stop. This was planned. I myself am a victim of rape. It's been over 30 years, and I want to say I admire this girl because she had enough guts to go and try to press charges against her rapist. That's something I think I can do. Notice I'm not wearing a mask today. Because for 30 years, over 30 years, I wore a mask and I denied it. See, I was afraid to tell anybody because my rapist was a relative and I wouldn't, you know, I knew I wouldn't have been believed because everybody would have believed him. You know, that's what they do. You know, this girl's got a long ride ahead of her. She's got to go to court. They're going to dig, you know, her background up and everything. She's going to be humiliated. That's not fair because we didn't do anything. She didn't do anything, did she? That's right. They did. And what are they being treated like? Yeah, they didn't even, what? Tackle them about to play football? Yeah, juvenile court, they should be tried as adults.
I mean, that is an adult crime. So why would those be charged as juvenile? Just a thought.
You know, I have two daughters of my own. You know, they're adult daughters. And, you know, I wouldn't want to be a parent to have to go through this with my child. Like I said, it's taken me 30 years to deal with it.
How many people do you think, sir?
And, you know, you always think, you know, everybody says, oh, it'll go away, she'll forget. No, you never forget. There's always something that will remind you, even now. You know, I still have dreams about it and what happened. It never goes away. So I want all the women that have been raped to come on up here with me. Let's do a group hug. Let's show the world what it's like to be a rape victim, yet we're not afraid of our attackers. Come on, ladies! Now, I don't know if the victim's out there or not, but I think we all of us that have been raped need to send her and her family letters of support. And we need to be there with her when she's in court. We need to help her get through this. No, even if you think you're a rape, come on, anyone.
We
are not going to be afraid. I don't even know if I was raped because I was drugged and I was catatonic, but I thank God for that. Scoop me up, and I didn't have to be there. My body wasn't there. I was somewhere else. So, God help me, and I hope this all the victims can become closer to God. You know, a rape victim, for a while, will pretend it didn't exist. We'll block it out for a while, but eventually, down the road, it's going to hit them. And, you know, they need to get counseling. They need to get some kind of help to deal with it, because it's hard. You know, like I said, it's been over 30 years for me, and 2 years ago, my rapist came around my daughter and started making comments, and it brought it all back. And I would do anything to protect my daughter. And I don't know about anybody. I can't see how the sheriff out here can't. I'm not saying it's his fault. I mean, maybe whatever. But if this was his daughter, or anybody that's out there and says it's the parents' fault for letting her go, come on, we're all kids. At one time, we lied to our parents, didn't we? You know, you can be the best parent in the world, and things are going to happen. You can't protect your children. You can't shield them. You can't blame the parents.
When I was 15, I was raped.
I didn't even get to choose the first time I had sex. I was drugged, carried limp. And then I reported it and nothing happened. They said that I just regretted what I did the night before and to get over it. So now I have 2 college degrees and I put it behind me and I'm raising women myself. Talk to your daughters like they're adults. Teach them about the monsters there.
These boys need to answer to what they did. These kids think they could post these pictures on YouTube. It makes them look cool or whatever. You know, we can't have this done anymore. You know, something needs to be done with kids that are doing this. If we have to, you know, all write to YouTube or whatever to close these videos down and not let them post it anymore.
My name is Robin. I'm 58 years old, and I was sexually assaulted 50 years ago as a child. At the time, they didn't want to take kids into court because they thought it would be too traumatic to run them through all that. So it was covered up, and I never got justice on that. And about 10 years after that, I saw an item in the paper that the man who molested me as a child was receiving an award for his voluntary services to young girls in our community. It made me sick. I want to say how proud I am of this woman for standing up for herself. And I know for every woman that has stood up, there are many, many who never stand up and never get justice. Please know that we have your back. Come on out here. If you have been assaulted, speak up. It is not your fault. It is not your fault. We're here for you.
Yeah, we are not ashamed. And that's going to be our chance from now on. Instead of get rid of sheriff, whatever, or whatever. We are not ashamed.
We are not ashamed. We are not ashamed. We are not ashamed. We are not ashamed. We are not ashamed. We are not ashamed.
My name is Katrinka. And I was 5 years old, and I was raped by 2 high school senior boys who were my babysitters. At the time, I thought I did something wrong. I never told anybody until I got married and told my husband. Then I told my dad. But I'll tell you what, I probably saved my dad prison time.
Okay.
Because he would have went after the bastards, and he would have killed them.
I'll text you one.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's okay to swear. I do it in different languages. It's okay. Hello, comrade. I was a rape victim. Mine was my boyfriend's best friend. I spoke earlier about it. But know that 1 in 4 are assaulted, but only 1 in 8 say something. So please, I beg you, this is not for women, because here I think they know they have the right. And anywhere, they have the right to say something. But I implore you, men, teach your sons chivalry. Teach them manners. Teach them how not to be monsters. Teach them that when you say no, whether it's with a smile on your face, a coquettish tone, take it seriously. Take it as if someone is yelling in your face, no. Jane Doe could not say no, but her unconsciousness should have been the word no to them. But they saw it as the word go. So we say, Reno, you have to go. We say, everyone who swept it under the rug, you have to go. And we say, justice for Jane Doe. Justice for Jane Doe.
My name is Michelle. I'm 51 years old. I actually molested when I was 8 years old by a relative. Never told anybody, kept it hidden, and finally in my 40s, I decided to get help. And my heart breaks for this little girl, because this is going to stick with her for the rest of her life. And no matter what, 20, 30 years from now, she's still going to be known as that rape victim. Nobody is going to remember her for the good things she does. She's just going to be remembered for this rape victim.
And I am asking you, and I am begging you, please do justice for this girl. You have no idea what it feels like as a woman to go through what I went through. And thank God for my family and my friends, and especially my friend Sandy, that saved my life. Thank you.
And to add to that, you know, to her friend, she will be remembered for being positive. She will be remembered for getting through it. She will be remembered for the one that cracked the case that brought the city down. She will be remembered for some positive. A lot of positive. Guys, do we believe in chivalry? How many married guys do we have? Married. We have married and still to remember. You gotta remember, women are a pedestal above us. They are a pedestal above us. I find it ironic that around here in this oppressed valley, because it is oppressed, that domestic violence is huge.
Oh, yeah.
That's where it's huge. It's too big.
Okay.
It has to go down. Correct? Would you agree? Can I get a testify? Can I get an amen? I know there's a bunch of churches in the valley. Who all attends church on Sunday morning here? Wow, really? Wow. That surprises me. Because there's a ton of churches. There's like 13,000 of them or something around here. Or 1,300. You gotta remember, you know, it's the area's too oppressed, and this is cracking it. And soon, when it all crumbles, we rebuild. We're gonna need a new sheriff. We're gonna need a new coach. We're gonna need a new assistant coach. And we're gonna need a new football team. It's gonna get better, but for right now, we're just pulling the roots out. Pulling the roots out. That's all we're doing, just pulling them out. Not the good ones. There's a lot of good people in Steubenville. There's a lot of good people in Steubenville. There's a lot of good people in the valley. I'm the father of a rape victim. There's people in this community that are worried about these young boys' future. This is not yet relieved from my daughter's mind after 7 years. During the trial, her rapist callously said, "How long is this going to take?" All I could think of was the rest of my daughter's life. As a father of a victim, I've tried to show my girl that not all men are like this, but only a few despicable few and their mothers that ignore the truth that they gave birth to a monster. I still get antagonized. My daughter still gets antagonized by family members of her rapist. This is not the first time that this has happened in this community. This has been a much rumored and hard to be proven ugly fact in this community until now.
Amen.
This is the last one. Pop quiz, ladies. What do you say to your boy that's laying on the ground with his hands between his legs, screaming in pain? Not a goddamn thing. You already told him no once.
My name's Alicia. I'm a citizen of Steubenville here. I was raped in 2000, reported it to the police, and instead of them doing anything for me, they called me and left a message on my answering machine saying that since he had drug charges in Weirton, West Virginia, that they couldn't do anything for me. So I appreciate everybody that's standing out here for this little girl. I feel like you're here for me as well. And everybody else has ever done, had to suffer through what I'm suffering through. Yes, I'm a college student. Yes, I'm at a university. But for 10 years, I was afraid to walk outside my house. I'm still afraid of this crowd, even though I know you're here for good things. It's like, I'm still scared of crowds. But I'm understanding what this little girl's going to go through. It's going to be for the rest of her life. Don't tell her that, oh, tomorrow it'll be okay, because it'll never be okay. She's going to walk around scared just as well as I am and any other lady in this, or male in this audience that's been through this. And don't try to push it down her throat. It's going to go away, because it never will. Thank you for listening to me. You guys have a good day.
Hello, my name is Angela. I'm 40. I was raped when I was 15, being taken to a school dance by a 19-year-old boy that I had a crush on. My parents and I went and talked to an attorney in this town, and nothing became of it. And I'm here to support this rape victim, because I was traumatized for 3 years. I couldn't stand a male, a boy, put their hands on me for 3 years. So thank you.
You want a hug? Can you see her? Give her a hug.
Hi, my name's Nicole. And when I was in the sixth grade, I was molested by my friend's brother. And then when I was 14, I was raped by my boyfriend. And in June of last year, I was attacked by my stepson while I was in the shower. If I did not fight back, it would have been another sexual assault, but I fought for my life because I didn't want it to happen again. Thank you all for being here for this girl.
That takes some guts to stand up here and say this. Let's hear it. Let's hug. That's amazing.
My name is Haley, and at the age of 14, I was raped by a star football player that I had a crush on. I thought he was so nice and the greatest thing in the world. And then he has to speak to me in a bathroom, and I'm tossed out. And I woke up to him in front of me, and I decided charges because it took place at my friend's house, and I didn't want to get my friends in trouble. And those friends didn't believe me. They thought that I wanted it. And you know what? I got new friends.
Yeah, we're your friends.
Amen.
We're your friends. You just made, what, how many people is here? A couple thousand? Sorry, yeah. Well, she just made 2,000 some new friends, yeah?
Hi, my name's Megan, and I'm from Tyran, Pennsylvania. My mother, my older sister, me, and my younger sister were all molested by the same man. And that was my mother's stepfather. None of her half-sisters or her mother or anybody in her family ever believed her. And after my younger sister committed suicide in July of 2008, I decided to break away from my family. And then my mother died, and that really made things bad. But I grew up as a child knowing what was going on with everybody, but I couldn't do anything, and I had nobody, and I was alone. And I won't put up with that anymore. Thank you.
That's the thing. You don't have to put up with it. Ladies, you don't have to put up with that. Come on. You don't have to put up with that. Some guy wants to push you. Don't put up with it. Say something. Come out. Fear. We don't live in fear anymore, do we? We're not going to live in fear anymore, are we? We're not going to live in this oppressed fear anymore, are we?
Never again. one thing. All the... There's a lot of news people here today. I want to ask you guys, can you go back to your stations? I want you guys to ask or start calling more attention to rape, doing shows or information things on what these girls need to know on how not to get raped. I have a young girl here that wants to say something. She's never been a victim of rape, but she's afraid she might get raped. So I'm going to let her talk.
I'm Lexis. I'm 11 years old, and I'm afraid I'm going to get raped. I just don't want this to happen to me.
But not in our community. Don't blame us.
We won't. These young girls need to learn how to stop somebody from raping them. You know, instead of... Yes. You know, there needs to be more awareness of rape. I think it kind of took a fast step there for a while.
Yeah, we gotta do the right thing. We've got to understand that we got a counselor here. We have a counselor here. If anybody wants to talk, he's here. That's a start. That's a start. No, it's not the sheriff's department. They counsel each other, I guess. I don't know. But, you know, I can't. There's a lot of happy people. You guys look cold. You guys cold? You guys fired up? You guys hungry? It is noon. Yeah, I was going to say, where's Route 22 Pizza? I thought they were coming. We're hungry for justice as well. Yeah, somebody... Yeah, justice... We're going to play some tunes for a minute, just sort of hang out. We're just going to hang out. Loosen up. We've heard a lot to digest. We have a lot, you know, to kind of sink in. We need solutions, yeah, we do, but we're just gonna hang for a few, kind of be cool. Yeah.
My name is Patty. I'm 54. I was raped when I was 14. I was a cheerleader in high school. I didn't want to be a cheerleader anymore because it made you too popular and everybody wanted to date you. And I was scared of guys. As a result of this, it has hindered my relationships all my life. I was raped again about 30 years ago, and I had to watch. I went to the police department to report it, and they told me that you don't want to do that. Your family owns a business. Your name's going to be drugged through the mud. They're going to hide it. But this guy's your word against his. You're going to be drugged all over TV. You'll never live it down. They told me to.
Thank you.
More or less, let it go, that I'd be better off. And they told me the best thing I could do is give him his name, and that if anything else happened, they would call me. Well, the guy came into the place of business that I was at weekly, and he would laugh, and I had to put up with it, and I wanted to hurt him so bad, and I couldn't. And a month later, I found out where I was working in a public place that a little 15-year-old girl got raped by the same guy. And justice wasn't served on him, not even yet today. And people had to take it in their own hands, and her brothers went out and beat the crap out of him. And I don't know. He's still out there. I don't know if he's still raping people, but I have to say something to this little girl. There was a song a long time ago. Okay, the answer, my friend, is to defend, and the answer is in the message that was sent. Yeah.
My name is Jensen, and I'm 18. I'm from Wintersville. When I was 13, someone from my own family raped me. Yeah, I partied, but that was no excuse for him to rape me. And because of him, I went out and did some stupid things, did drugs, drank. And to this day, I do not forgive him. And then, my best friend's boyfriend decided that she wasn't good enough, so he decided that he was going to tag team. So, here I am today, going to college. I have a wonderful boyfriend, and he knows what no means. So, you know what?
Yeah, guys, you gotta remember that. No means no. No means no.
No means no.
No means no.
No means no.
No means no.
No means no.
No means no.
No means no. It don't work. We gotta start fighting back. I've been raped 3 different times in 3 different occasions in 3 different states. It's got to stop! Everybody's got to stand up and speak for themselves. You got to reach out. Look for a good friend and stay with them. That's all that counts. Support! We need all the support we can get, and this needs to be a lot bigger than what it is. Everybody needs to grow up. That's right. We will support. I'm tired of hearing everybody saying, I've been raped and I'm not going to do nothing about it. It's time to start doing something about it. I was 6 years old when it first happened to me. It was my brother and a next door neighbor guy. And they both got away with it because the police didn't do a damn thing. I'm growing up, I have my own children, and my son was molested. You know, so it doesn't just happen to you girls out there. It does happen to boys, too. And we gotta stand up and be strong!
I wanna ask, I don't know if we're gonna do any more of these in the next couple weeks. The next time, I would love to see everybody out there wearing teal ribbons in support of rape victims. Also, I'd like to see a night vigil with candles to support them. You girls think? This is in memory of every girl that has ever been raped, and boy, there are men that have been raped too, so we can't leave them out. So we'll let somebody organize this.
And here's the thing, if you ladies up here, you've gotten through this, you can get through anything. Am I correct? If you get through this, you can get through anything.
I just spoke a little bit ago. I just wanted to say, you know, as a result of having to shut my mouth and live with it and not being able to stay married and didn't want to have any kind of life at all, and becoming a person that never wanted to come on my house, didn't want to go to the mall, get out of my car, was afraid of everything, that I have been on anxiety and antidepressants all my life, and nobody stood up, and nobody, everything, rape is a shame, and it should not be that, and I'm so glad that everybody's here, and I'm glad to support this, and I'm really glad that we're going to support this young girl, that she don't have to live with this silent torture for the rest of her life. Thank you.
And you know, there's a lot of us here with our masks on today. These ladies ain't wearing any masks. They're not wearing any masks.
We're not ashamed.
They're not
ashamed. We're not ashamed. It's time to open up.
Hi, I'm Trisha May. Before I came here today, my little boy asked me, "Where are you going, Mom?" I said, "Because I'm going to be her voice. I'm going to stand up for her because I couldn't speak. My 9-year-old little boy says, Mom, that would never happen. I would never do something like that because I know that you would kill me. I looked at my 9-year-old and I said, you know what? I will not only kill you, I will first cut your penis off, shove it down your throat, and watch you die slowly. Because no female, no man needs to go through this. People need to stand up, speak up, and have a voice. Abdallah, you should be ashamed of yourself.
Hi, my name is Holly. I was 14, and I was raped, and the man took away the one thing that I can never get back. I was too scared to tell anybody about what happened. I was embarrassed. I thought it was my fault. It was all me, because I was at a party, and we were drinking. And I said no, repeatedly, and I was pinned down, and there's no way I could have moved. And I wish I would have had the bravery of this young girl today to speak up and to tell what really happened to me. But I kept silent for years. And my God, I hope she gets the justice that she deserves. Thank you. My name is Sarah. I grew up here. I was born and raised here. I've had an instance in my life too, one of which when I was 15 by football players, one of which when I was in my mid-20s. The one in my mid-20s, I was left at a bar by my boyfriend drunk. Next thing I knew, I woke up to someone forcing themselves on me in a car. I shoved them off, tried to get home. Next thing I knew, I woke up in my apartment naked and violated. I don't know who did it. I don't know how many people there were. But I want to say that not all people in this town are bad, because there was one man, one boy that I went to high school with that actually told me what happened and told me who the perpetrators were who raped me, gang raped me, when I was unconscious. And I appreciate him. Thank you. And I'm here for this girl to stand up for her. And I don't think it's right. I think it's a society problem. These boys shouldn't be getting away with this stuff. It's girls are too afraid to speak up. And I commend the man that finally did speak up for me. Thank you.
Hey, everybody. My name is Robin. I'm also a victim of rape. But let me know, I have dedicated my life to helping other girls that's gone through what I've gone through, because I know the long-term effects. So I am a psychiatric nurse, mental health, and I would like to talk to anybody that needs to talk to me, because I know what you're going through, and I know the long-term effects that it has on everybody, on the victims, and I am here for the victim. And if anybody needs to talk, I can stand down here if you need to talk. Thanks.
Hey everybody. Happy New Year. It's 2013, and I'm also a victim of a horrific experience, but you know why these boys did this? Not because they thought they were going to get caught, because they thought they were going to get away with it. They thought they were going to get away with it because of the corruption that is going on, not just here, but all over the country and all over the world. And we're here. I'm from Houston, Texas. I just moved here. Why I came to the Valley, I'm here for a reason. We're all here for a reason. And we're all here to support this girl and to stand together for what we believe in, for what's right. Honesty, ethics, morals, values, they're lost in the politicians these days. We want these people out of our system. We want them gone. Why is evidence coming up missing? Citizens can't take that. We didn't take that evidence. On the way here,
People were telling me, my grandmother said, oh, read the front page of the newspaper. Don't go to the protest. People are going to be arrested. I said, Grandma, they can't arrest me for practicing my constitutional rights. I have a right to be here peacefully protesting for what we believe in as a country. As a country, we stand for peace, we stand for honesty and justice, not just for ourselves, but for everybody. Thank you for being here.
Happy New Year. Like you said, this is a good way to start a year, 2013. 2013 is the year that, well, it crumbled. The empire, the big red empire crumbled. Am I correct?
Yeah.
Not everybody, but it's cracking. This is the year it starts at 13. Unlucky, lucky, I don't know.
Hi, my name's Julie. I'm at Julesy on Twitter. You guys probably, a lot of you probably follow me. I'm a big advocate of anonymous. I found April Whip's rape victim. I found her. I personally called her mother. I did a lot of research with Twitter and with Printify.com, and we went together, and I personally found her. No, I've never spoken to her, but I speak with her mom every day between text and phone calls. The rumor is that she's recanted. She hasn't. And first of all, in the state of Ohio, the age of consent for sex is 16. The girl was 14. Even if she said it was consensual, guess what? It was rape. So the police have to do something about it today.
Well, what's going to happen if they don't? Because they keep saying that, well, we've seen everything. Maybe we should just air the video so everybody gets to hear it, so they have to listen to it. I mean, I got it queued up and ready. All I got to do is hit play, and they have to stand here and listen to it. I mean, if you're like, well, we didn't see the video, and then we did see the video, we don't. Make your mind up, please. I mean, I'm just saying, I don't know who's saying what. I just know you see, you don't, you don't. All we want is the truth. All we want is honesty. All we want is justice. We're not out to hang anybody. We're out to simply the truth. Come forward, say something. Here's what you did. You know, we've seen it, we didn't see it, whatever. We had it. The cover-up stuff's got to go. It's not a healthy way to live. It brings oppression to the valley. You've been oppressed for years, 30 years, 40 years now, 30 years, I know.
Thank you.
42 for her. Just come out and say something. If you did it, if you said it, if you seen it, you know, bring in the justice. It's not, football is not worth, football is not worth, you know, morality. It's not worth morality. The game, the system, the money, it's not worth morality. Would you agree?
Yes,
would you agree? I like sports as much as the next guy, but when there's a system, a corrupt system underneath of it, that's not winning, and I, for one, am not jealous of Big Red Football. I'm not jealous. Sorry, I'm not that late. Yeah, it's not late for death, and now we're talking about it, and the system has to be brought up. We just want to come forward and say what you did. We're not out to, you know, nobody's going to get crucified here. We just want some questions answered. I mean,
if the student would be afraid to go back to school if they step forward,
that's
a problem.
That's how my friend
Alex is. They shouldn't be afraid. Be protected by the school.
I'm wearing this mask today in support of everybody that's here, the sign of unity. I'm taking this mask off of the ladies that came up here without a mask on. And it's a crying shame how many ladies sit here, and there's a lot more. That's the tip of the iceberg, because there's a lot of them that are afraid to speak out. These are our daughters. These are our sisters. These are our wives. One of my family members stood right up here. We need to stop the system by teaching our kids right now what is right and wrong. We can blame anybody we want to blame. We need to teach our children right from wrong. Hold them accountable. I have five children, three daughters and two boys. They were taught how to respect each other. They were taught honesty, justice, truth, and they're all here. So don't forget, it's about the victim. We stand behind her and raise your children right and hold the people in office accountable. Do not let this get brushed under the rug. You ladies that are up here, God bless you. We have your back.
That was awesome from a guy. That was awesome. Guys, we got to support women, man. We got to do something. We got to change this system around. It's disrespect. And, you know, and I see a lot in the media. I see the celebrities. I see the, you know, they're all getting away with stuff. It's the system. It's just the higher up. That has to start there. I think it's Chris Brown that hit a chick, I think.
Yeah.
Yeah. You know what I mean? Like, that's where it begins.
Yeah, but
they're
back together.
And you got away with it. That's the problem. And then we see these guys around here trying to get away with it. Oh, and then we got Toby that kind of let him get away with it. That's the problem. You see what I mean? It's just a system. That has to crack. That has to crumble. It starts today. Correct? I love you all. You're all beautiful. Hi. Come on. Wake up. Hi. Hello. We're good people up here. There's a lot of good people. A lot of beautiful people. Even the ones with the mask. They're beautiful too. Adela, he's beautiful. Hi. Oh, come on. Okay, well, you're beautiful, sir. I've seen you on TV a lot. I get a hug. I'm kind of like, wow. All right. Anyway, we're here. That's just it. I mean, we just need somebody to run against him, really. That's a vote. I mean, that's all it takes. We're in a system, a dramatic system where we vote. So if somebody says, hey, I want to be sheriff and run against him, start something. Start a campaign. That's just get him out of office. If you don't like him, get him out of office. He's right here at the voting system. But if the voting system's rigged, we'll find out. Like we found out about this. You know, if the voting system's rigged, with everybody else in the media, it's all rigged. If it is, we'll find out. We already know. Yeah, truth. That's it. We just want truth. Everybody's head on a platter. We just want truth. I wish the head coach was here. I'd like to talk to him. Where's Reno? Does the fella know where he is? Do you know where Reno is? Can you call him? Do you have him show up?
He's here.
Can we have him show up?
Would you
happen to know where he is right now? Like, Reno. You don't know where he is? Come on. Cut the music, guys.
Okay, sir.
Oh, dear.
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is Sheriff Adela. If you want something to say,
No profanity. I'm not going to stand here and try to convince you that I'm not the bad guy. You've already got your minds made up. But I'm going to tell you that the first lady that spoke.
Let him speak, buddy.
The first lady that spoke, I was hurt by what she was saying, how she was molested. And the rest of you women that come up here, it's heartbreaking to hear the stories of how you were sexually assaulted, especially at such a young age. Yes, I do have two daughters, beautiful daughters, and I have four granddaughters.
Hold on. Let him speak. Let him speak.
Let him talk.
Let him talk, please. This is a fair system. We're going to let him...
When I came into this office, I made a commitment to myself in 1985 that I would go after those people that have raped or those people that have sexually abused our young children. In the last 28 years, me and my officers, Captain Bell, have arrested over 200 plus individuals for sexually abusing children. And we taught our children about strangers all the time. Of the nearly 250 plus or close to 300 people that we have been arrested, not one was a stranger. Because these people said behind, it was someone they knew. We've arrested fathers and grandfathers and stepfathers and mom's boyfriends. And some of these mothers that bring these boyfriends in their house and they abuse their children. We've arrested school teachers.
Let him talk. Let him talk.
Okay, let him talk, please.
The most difficult thing.
Hold on.
Let me say something. I go into schools and have been the last many years talking with children about sexual abuse and strangers. And now I have to go into schools and tell these children that are three and third grade or fourth graders, it's not just strangers. It's someone you may know. And they probably think, well, the sheriff's crazy. When I say it could be your grandpa or your dad, or your cousins. The most difficult thing, and I'll end this, the most difficult thing for me to do is to sit and listen to a 3 or 4 year old child tell you what an individual did to them. It's like taking a knife and sticking it in your heart and twisting it. It's difficult. And of all the people that we have arrested have been convicted. And when the woman said she would like to take that knife, I would like to be able to do things with these individuals that have molested these children, but I can't do that.
Thank you, sir. Can I get another hug?
Where's the man in
there?
What time is this? Where is it? The sign that says it shouldn't hurt to be a child? Or it shouldn't hurt?
The sign on my vehicle, and it's been on there for years, it says it shouldn't hurt to be a child. Report child abuse. Well,
do you support freedom of comment?
I would like to ask one question though. Adela, if I can ask one question. Sheriff Adela, can I ask you just one question? And I like I said, I don't know. I just hear all kinds of stuff. You're aware of the video, correct?
Right.
You're right?
I am aware. We're talking about the video that
the 12 minutes.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah. Can you tell us exactly when you seen that?
The first time I saw that was 3 days ago.
I just wanted to make it clear. I'm not trying to set him up. I'm just asking. I just want his answer.
You can believe me or not believe me. You're going to believe what you want to believe. I saw it 3 days ago. We were aware that there was a video out there like that. Steubenville Police Department had that in their possession in August. It's a disgusting video. But I never saw it until 3 days ago.
Real quick, hold on, real stuff. Hey. Can you tell us your first reaction to the video? What you thought? What was in your head? What were you thinking?
Regardless, it was disgusting, it's nauseating, it's sickening. Like I said, you can't arrest somebody for being stupid, but when I hear... Can I finish? When I'm hearing on the video, she's as dead as Kaylee Anthony, or she's as dead as Trayvon Martin, or if it was my daughter, I would let her leave her dead. Disgusting is what I said it was, and I say it again the same day today.
Thank you, sir. Let's hear it for a fellow. Thank you.
Listen. I want to say something, and I hope that you listen, okay? There are two sides of everything, okay? The sheriff's a good man, and I know it. And I know he's in the past, hear me out. For 15 years, I dated a lady here that I'm still with. She's dying from cancer. I just spent every single night sleeping on the cot at the hospice. Okay, her mother was a sergeant from the sheriff's department, Helen Carocci. And she started the Child Advocacy Center. And she worked under the sheriff's direction to prosecute rapists and abusers of children. So I believe him. And I believe he's a good man. Listen, no, you hear this, all right? Please. Because I'll tell you what, I spoke up in this community once before when Clinton was here in defense of children being killed by abortion. And this is a picture of me, what they did. A couple weeks later, I spent a week in intensive care in a hospital. They ransacked my house, and they set me up. So I'm taking a risk right now speaking up, so please hear me out. I have no mask on, okay? I'm not downing this chair. He's a good man, and I know it. I know it from 15 years of being with a woman that was on his department that died a few years ago. But the thing is that there's a good old boys thing in this town. And when you speak up against one, then they come after you. I spoke up against the Democratic Party, which they control. They came after me. And they tried to kill me. And I have proof. Here is the problem here. Stop cops. Here is the problem. The head coach goes to defense for boys that commit crimes instead of sticking up for the victim. And he goes to that. I was held up here. This is all true. I'm not a liar. I tell the truth. I was held up here years ago by gun. Armed robbery. The kid that held me up, Damian Harris was his name. He got off. Because the coach went to the judge and the prosecutor, and I got proof, and he got off and he walked the street and played on the football team. This was years ago, and the same stuff is still happening. This is what's got to end. This is what's got to end.
Yeah!
Woo! Now I've been in Steubenville. This is a good community, and there are good people in this community, believe me. And it's a shame, a crying shame, that some bad and some corruption, oh yeah, you better believe there's corruption everywhere, is bringing down and hurting this good community and the good people. There are good officers on the police force. There are real good ones. There are good sheriffs in the sheriff's department. Okay, there are good people, and there are good kids on that football team. But there is an injustice here. There are lies and injustice and cover-ups. And if you want to do something about it from this point on, start teaching your children to respect life. That abortion is wrong. You teach these kids that they can have babies killed. How are they going to respect women? I'm just kidding. You got to love one another. This is what we were taught by Jesus Christ. To love one another. And that's what we need to do.
Happen to me because I
spoke up. And that's what goes on in this community. That's what goes on.
Here's the
deal.
Yeah. We are not here.
This is the victim.
As much as I love the Bible and everything it says, we're not here to push it. I refuse to do that. We refuse to do that. I'm sorry. But we are lucky to believe in a lot of things around here. There's Muslims here, there's Christians here, there's atheists, there's agnostics. We're all, you know, it's just a title, it's just a name, it's just a club. We're all together without it, you know what I mean? So, you know, if you believe this, if you believe that, that's fine. We need to coach this.
You're right.
We need to be cool.
Yeah.
Am I correct?
Yeah.
Are we all the same human race?
Yeah.
Are we all brothers and sisters?
Yes!
Are we all brothers and sisters?
Yeah! Yes.
I love you all. Tell somebody you love them. Give somebody a hug. Come on, we're hearing a lot of stuff. We're hearing a lot of dirt. We're hearing a lot of...
Woo!
We're hearing a lot of disgusting stuff. You don't need to hear it anymore. We're going to keep hearing it because we got a lot of people over here. But it's a lot to digest, And just remember,
you're
all brothers and sisters. Doesn't matter what you believe, who you believe. Be cool, be happy, and make sure nobody gets hurt. We love you. Correct? Do you love each other? Do you love us?
We love you!
We're here for you. Now you just gotta stand up for yourself.
But I've been here, now this is my second time that I've been here at this rally, and I stand here because my daughter, my six-year-old daughter, sleeps every other weekend with a child molester. Thanks to Jefferson County Court, the guy that I speak about actually went to a police station, a local police station, and gave an admission to a police officer that he did not know why he touched the minors and that he needed help. Yet he sleeps with my daughter.